مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم.
Telling that one has performed Hajj and Umrah certain times is not a sin in every case. It is stated in a hadith, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. Deeds are dependent upon intentions. With the intention of expressing gratitude for a divine favor bestowed upon a person, if he informs others that he has performed Hajj and Umrah certain times, there is no harm in it. However, in the present era, it is very difficult to rectify one's intention and to avoid the danger of ostentation due to the lack of religious knowledge and the company of righteous people. Suppose, without being asked, you inform someone that you have performed two Hajjs. He asks you, "Why did you tell it to me?" If you nervously tell him that you have informed him to express gratitude for a divine bounty, he may get silent. But you should ponder whether you had really intended to express gratitude for a divine bounty or not. If you had this intention, it was fine. Otherwise, you would end up committing the sin of lying. Furthermore, it may also lead to hypocrisy because of saying something that is contrary to, against one's feelings and thoughts. Ma'azallahi azza wa jal. If he had the intention of ostentation in his heart while telling it, he would be charged with double ostentation because of declaring an ostentatious act to be a means of expressing gratitude for a divine bounty. Anyway, it is a Madani request that everyone should observe Qufl-e Madina of the tongue, because an apparently minor looking slip of the tongue may lead to hell. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Madina, Madina.